In this lecture, we will understand what is double sideband suppressed carrier modulation or DSB-SC modulation and different characteristics of the DSB-SC modulated signal. In the transmission of the amplitude modulated signal, we had a carrier signal, an upper sideband and a lower sideband signal. This amplitude modulated signal can be shown in the frequency domain as here carrier signal has the frequency equal to fc and the two sidebands can be placed on the either side of the carrier signal based on their frequency. Lower sideband has the frequency plus minus fc minus fm and upper sideband has the frequency plus minus fc plus fm. So when we modulate the carrier signal according to the message signal, then we get an amplitude modulated signal which has two sidebands and a carrier signal on both of the sides, or message signal is shifted to the frequency fc in the negative and positive side, and also the amplitude of the shifted signal is reduced by 50%. The transmission of a signal which contains a carrier signal along with the two sidebands can be termed as double sideband full carrier system or simply DSB-SC system. The transmission of the message signal in this way is not efficient as we previously saw, because the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal or eta is defined as modulation index k square divided by 2 plus k square. The amount of power dissipated by the carrier signal or PC is equal to 2 by 2 plus k square into total power of the amplitude modulated signal. When the modulation index k is equal to 1, then the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal can be calculated as 33%. The amount of power dissipated by the carrier signal can be given by PST by PC is equal to 2 divided by 2 plus 1 whole square to 100%, or PC divided by PST is equal to 2 by 3 into 100%, which can be simplified as 66%. So 66% of the total power is dissipated on the carrier signal. So the efficiency of the amplitude modulation is only 33.33%, and carrier itself dissipates 66% of the total power, but it carries no information. This amount of power is fully wasted on a carrier signal which carries no information, because the information is only contained in upper and lower sidebands. Now, in order to increase the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal, in the transmission of the amplitude modulated signal, the carrier signal is suppressed, and saved power by suppressing the carrier signal is distributed between upper and lower sideband. The process of suppressing the carrier signal and distributing the power to the sidebands in the transmission of the amplitude modulated signal is known as the double sideband suppressed carrier or DSB-SC modulation. After suppressing the carrier signal, we will have two sidebands on both sides at the frequency plus minus FC plus FM and plus minus FC minus FM, but we will not have any carrier signal either at the frequency plus FC or minus FC. So the DSB-SC modulated signal contains an upper sideband, a lower sideband, and the carrier signal is suppressed. Let's see the mathematical analysis for the generation of the DSB-SC modulated signal. Let's say modulating signal or message signal MT is equal to AM cos omega MT or AM cos 2 pi FMT, and the carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos omega CT or AC cos 2 pi FCT. So the double sideband suppressed carrier signal or ST is equal to MT into CT, or ST is equal to MT into AC cos 2 pi FCT, which can be written as ST is equal to AC into MT into cos 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 1, and this is the standard equation for DSB-SC modulated signal. Now let us calculate the bandwidth of the DSB-SC modulated signal. From the equation number 1, we have the DSB-SC modulated signal ST is equal to AC into MT into cos 2 pi FCT. If we put the value of MT as AM cos 2 pi FMT, then ST can be written as AC into AM into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now multiply and divide the equation by 2, then ST can be written as AC into AM divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Apply the formula of 2 cos A cos B, which is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B in the following equation, or modulated signal ST can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. Identify this as equation number 2. Here, FC is the frequency of the carrier signal, FM is the frequency of the message signal, and FC minus FM, which is the minimum frequency, is the frequency of the lower sideband, and FC plus FM, which is the maximum frequency, is the frequency of the upper sideband. Bandwidth of a signal is the difference between maximum frequency and the minimum frequency, or bandwidth of this DSB-SC modulated signal BW is equal to F maximum minus F minimum. Now, if we put the value of F maximum as FC plus FM and F minimum as FC minus FM, then the bandwidth of the DSB-SC modulated signal or BW is equal to FC plus FM minus FC minus FM, or BW is equal to FM plus FM, or BW will be equal to twice of FM. Let us calculate the power of DSB-SC modulated signal. From the equation number 2, we can write DSB-SC modulated signal ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. So the DSB-SC modulated signal is consist of upper sideband signal, which is equal to AC into AM divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, and lower sideband signal, which is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. All of them are cosine signals, and the power of a cosine signal can be given by P is equal to VRMS square by R, and VRMS can be replaced by VM by root 2. So power of the cosine signal is equal to VM by root 2 whole square divided by R. Here, VRMS is the RMS value of the cosine signal and VM is the amplitude of the cosine signal. As the DSB-SC signal is the sum of two sidebands, so the total power of the DSB-SC signal or PST is equal to power of upper sideband or PUSB plus power of lower sideband or PLSB. Upper sideband and lower sideband has the amplitude of AM into AC divided by 2. If we put this amplitude in the formula of the power of cosine signal, then power of the DSB-SC modulated signal or PST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 divided by root 2 whole square divided by R plus AM into AC divided by 2 divided by root 2 whole square divided by R, which can be simplified as AM into AC divided by 2 root 2 whole square divided by R plus AM into AC divided by 2 root 2 whole square divided by R. Now, if we square the terms, then power of the DSB-SC modulated signal or PST is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 8 divided by R plus AM square into AC square divided by 8 divided by R. If we simplify this, then power of the DSB-SC modulated signal or PST is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 8R plus AM square into AC square divided by 8R, which can be simplified as 2 into AM square into AC square divided by 8R. Finally, the power of DSB-SC modulated signal is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 4R. Now, let us calculate the efficiency of the DSB-SC modulated signal. Efficiency eta is equal to usable power by total power. Here, usable power is the power of upper sideband or lower sideband or PUSB or LSB is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 8R. And the total power is the sum of power of upper sideband and the power of lower sideband, as each of the sideband has the power AM square into AC square divided by 8R. The sum of power of two sidebands or the total power of the DSB-SC modulated signal is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 4R. Now, if we put this value of usable power and the total power in the equation of the efficiency of the DSB-SC modulated signal, then eta is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 8R divided by AM square into AC square divided by 4R. After performing some mathematical calculation, eta is equal to half, or eta is equal to 50%. So the efficiency of the DSB-SC modulated signal is equal to 50%. Now let us calculate the current in the DSB-SC modulated signal. The total power of the DSB-SC modulated signal or PST is equal to AM square into AC square divided by 4R. Now, AC square divided by 2R can be written as power of the carrier signal or PC. So, the total power PST is equal to PC into AM square divided by 2. Now, this total power can be replaced by I square R, where I is the total current, and the carrier power or PC can be replaced by IC square R, where IC is the carrier current. Then it can be simplified as I square is equal to IC square into AM square divided by 2, or I is equal to root over IC square into AM square divided by 2. Finally, the current in the DSB-SC modulated signal or I is equal to IC into root over AM square divided by 2. Now, let us calculate the voltage in the DSB-SC modulated signal. Again, the total power PST is equal to PC into AM square divided by 2. This PST or total power can be replaced by V square by R, and the PC or carrier power can be replaced by VC square by R. Now, if we simplify the equation, then it can be written as V square is equal to VC square into AM square divided by 2. if we calculate the value of voltage in the DSBSC modulated signal, then V is equal to root over VC square into M square divided by 2, which can be further simplified as V is equal to VC into root over AM square divided by 2, where VC is the voltage of the carrier signal. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.